particularly in areas where there's high concentration of cases, or if you have to do things like go to a grocery store where you can't keep that 6-foot distance, then masks are important to use, but they want to emphasize there's just one thing you need to use. You still need to use that facial, that 6-foot distance, because it's important for all of us to stay safe. And wash your hands over and over again, Dr. Gomez. Thank you very much. So that's enough. The new cruise ship nightmare. Two dying on board. Others sick with the coronavirus. Where do they go now? And throughout the program tonight, this spotlight moments that unite us like this standing ovation for healthcare workers by another set of heroes, members of the New York City Fire Department. Just imagine being trapped for days on a cruise ship as a deadly outbreak of the virus spreads. The latest nightmare
was... That'd be a dumb idea on a fucking cruise during an outbreak.
Why the fuck did they go?
COVID-19 symptoms. Let me see Sam Brown. I made my down deposit.
Mm-hmm.
Tonight, news of another tragedy striking at sea.
South by Southwest. I'm like, whoa. This is crazy. The store was planning on keeping the OR open, and they canceled my show in the main room, and they offered me a spot in the OR. I was like, I don't think we should be doing shows. Like, this doesn't seem like... This seems like it's getting real. It's like, because if you make a mistake, and there's a 14-day period where all these people can get infected, who the fuck knows who gets infected during those 14 days? Because we didn't know what it was yet. Still, we don't know what it is. It's still strange because so many people... Idris Elba apparently is asymptomatic. He's not showing any symptoms, and he has asthma. And I was reading something to find out if this is true, that somewhere in the neighborhood of 60% of the people are asymptomatic. And I wonder if that means they never show symptoms, or I wonder if that means they're asymptomatic for a certain period of time, so 60% of the people infected asymptomatic, but a certain percentage of those people will ultimately get the cold or get the cough and all the terrible symptoms. The fever.
Because you really have to listen. You know a lot of people. And I know a lot of people. And nobody's called me yet.
That has it? I have. Michael Yo. Michael Yo was almost dead. Michael Yo went to New York City, did Gotham. He came back. He got real sick. He got...
No.
Yes. He got pneumonia and the COVID-19 at the same time. So we got coronavirus and pneumonia. And he said, now 6 days ago, I talked to him 2 days ago, he said four days before that, he thought he was gonna die. He said, I couldn't breathe. Pneumonia and this coronavirus, I think this motherfucker it like plays with you. If you don't have it, if you don't get it, you can kind of like go, this is no big deal. But if you do get it, it fucking grabs you. Like, Jamie knows a girl who's 21 who lost her sense of smell and taste. And it wrecks people. We were Googling a story about this Olympic swimmer from South Africa, 31, stud athlete, Olympic swimmer. Said this virus fucked him up. He said it was the worst thing he's ever experienced. So it's weird. It's like it almost like plays with our mind. Like, it makes some people seem like they're immune and some people are fine. Maybe it's you. Take a chance. Go outside.